الحديث.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأنصاره وأزواجه وأتباعه وذريته أجمعين. The brother asked me about محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام brother childhood. And I'm gonna tell him something very strange. By the way, Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام, his father died before he born. He never saw his, never seen his father. But I want you to know the kafir woman, the kafir decent mother. When Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام was young baby, she very scared about him. She is very caring, and what she said, because Mecca, if you know Mecca, it was a country who is visited by visitors from all over the world, and they bring diseases and they bring infection. So anyone in the childhood living in Mecca, very difficult to survive. They have to send him far away to a woman to feed him. Look how the caring of the mother starts from the beginning. And there is a season for women to come to Arabia, to Mecca, to choose the family, the best family who can pay the best price to feed the kids. Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام, the descendant of the most honorable family in history. Descendant from Adam to Ibrahim عليه السلام. And that's how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose him. The verse in Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى Adam عليه السلام ونوحا وآل إبراهيم وآل عمران. Allah has chosen Adam and سيدنا نوح عليه السلام and the descendant of Abraham and the descendant of آل عمران over the whole world. So he's from the best family, and his mother gave him to حليمة, حليمة السعدية. And his mother didn't have much. He didn't have much to pay. And look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to honor Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam when he was little baby. The sheep. Once Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam came to her house, the blessing of Allah started to roll in. The blessing, and she was shocked. How come I took the poorest one of all the children and all this blessing coming to me? And after he been fed, she have to send him again, because the Mecca language is mixed with all the different accent. She want him to learn the pure Arabic language. And you just hear it from, like, now you find Arabs using English word, French word, because language are mixed together. But look how she cares. She want him to learn the best language. And then his brother, in feeding, he saw the event when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to clean. His brother saw an operation done by Jibreel alayhi salam to clean his heart from any evil. And when he grown up, he started to be the most honest shepherd. And Shaitan is the profession of the prophets. It's not McDonald's, it's not KFC. ما من نبي إلا رعى. All the prophets, they was shepherd. Why? Because shepherd, when you do shipping, shepherd, you learn a lot of things. You learn, you become close to Allah. You don't imagine. You don't imagine this sky. How many millions of stars you see at night? You don't know. See the miracle. Anyway, this is the way he grown up. Then he become, when he was not prophet, he was a Sadiq al-Amin, the truthful and the trustworthy.
You really find to find you, like, how long
I want. No, I'm not Mercury. I'm not Mercury. I'm not higher.
No, but I know your place now.
Blame him. He told me that the sun gonna hit you and you're gonna be hit by the sun.
لا حول ولا قوة.
May Allah bless you.
السلام عليكم حبيبي. How is everything?
Allah bless
you. ما شاء الله تبارك الله. السلام عليكم.
Look at these faces, brother. Look, subhanAllah. Look at the people who come say hello. And look at the sun of Muta. And look at the sun of Sharmusa. And look at the sun of Mataqiyah. Anyway, Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام in his childhood, in his when he was young, known in all Arabia as Sadiq al-Amin, the most truthful, the most trustworthy. His house used to be like Barclays Bank now. Everybody want to deposit something, he put in his house. Can you imagine? You put your gold, your money in his house. And when he grown up, this is just small things happen in his life. حلف الفضول. They ask him to come, the cover, ask him to do alliance. What is this alliance? Alliance for good deeds. Alliance for protection. The stranger, allying to feed the stranger, alliance will help the fudul. Fadala, something good. Yafdulu, fahuwa fadilun, wa fadail, wa fudul. So many good things. And when he became Prophet عليه السلام, he said, "Inni du'ita fil jahiliya." I was being called in jahiliya to alliance. If I call to it now, I accept it. You know why? Because Islam always for fudul and fadila and good deeds. And last story about Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. When the kuffar of Mecca have a debate, who will raise the black stone? Because it fell. And every tribe once said, I will take it, I lift it, and they start to fight together. And he was coming, and he said, Ja'a al-Sadiq al-Amin. This is the man, the most truthful, the most just, the most trustworthy. Let us how we're gonna say it. And he said, what the problem? And he said, they fighting, who gonna raise this stone? And he said, I tell you, bring something like a blanket or a sheet, big sheet, and we put the stone over the sheet, and everybody hold from one side, and we lift it up, and I put it in its place. Look, the wisdom. He convinced all the tribes to listen to him and take part in something, and who got the honor? Him, he installed the stone in its place. And when the beginning of Jibreel alayhi salam came to him, هي وانت خديجة رضي الله عنها وارضاها ام المؤمنين. The woman, he said, Allah built her a palace in paradise. And her uncle was there, Waraka ibn Nawfal. May Allah bless him. He was a Christian and muwahhid. And when Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام was complaining to Khadija, and he told him, يا محمد إن قومك مخرجيك. Oh Muhammad, your people are gonna throw you out. And the Prophet said, أو مخرجي. Really? They're gonna kick me out? And he said this, and how come? ما من رجل جاء بما جئت به إلا أخرجوه. There is no man in history brought what you brought until they kick him out. So get ready. So brother and sister, this is a lesson for us. This is a lesson for us.
Say goodbye.
This is a lesson for us that da'wah different than dakhwa. When you do real da'wah, you will have enemy. But alhamdulillah, wallahi al-azim, we who say it as the same as Imam Shafi'i. We are right, could be wrong. And they are wrong, could be right. We know, because we follow all our scholars suffer in all their life. And the life now, they are in jail. So we are not follow fake scholar. Does it cost us? Nothing. Because whatever we have, وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله. Whatever you had is from Allah. We're using money, Allah give us money. We're using health, Allah give us health. Are you gonna stop? إن شاء الله no. نحن الذين بايعنا محمدا. We promise and we pledge to Muhammad عليه السلام to carry on till we drop dead. السلام. Read the seerah, brother. Read the seerah. Read this book. I am Bismillah. Read the book. Those people who speak English, read this book. Al-Wala wal-Bara. This is, I went to buy it yesterday and the man said me, I said, what the other part? He said, only one part. I said, if this one part, why did he say part one? And by the blessing of Allah today, I met the brother who translated, the owner of Al-Firdaus Limited, and he promised me to bring me the three parts. I ask you, the brother who speaks English, a book written by Muhammad Sa'id Al-Qahtani, the best of Wala Ubara. And I promise you, this book I'm going to give it today, inshallah, present Al-Rahiq Al-Makhtoum, the Sealed Nectar, one of the best books written about Muhammad alayhi salam biography by Muhammad Al-Mubarak Furi. An Indian man wrote the best book about the Prophet alayhi salam seerah, Al-Wala wal-Bara and Al-Rahiq Al-Makhtoum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Thank you, Omar.
May Allah bless you.
I was winding it up because I haven't got much power left.
You know what I'm going to do?
Yeah.
I'm going to take the brother now.
Right.
Power station or whatever it is. I'm going to stick it to my phone till we finish eating and I give it to him when we finish because I need to upload something.
Give me the bloody. Do some more research for next week.
You.